The God of our fathers has glorified his servant Jesus, whom you handed over and denied in Pilate's presence when he had decided to release him. You denied the holy and righteous one and asked that a murderer be released to you. The author of life you put to death, but God raised him from the dead. Of this we are witnesses. Now I know, brothers, that you acted out of ignorance, just as your leaders did. But God has thus brought to fulfillment what he had announced beforehand through the mouth of all the prophets, that his Christ would suffer. Repent, therefore, and be converted, that your sins may be wiped away. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. A reading from the first letter of St. John. My children, I am writing this to you so that you may not commit sin. But if anyone does sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ, the righteous one. He is expiation for our sins, and not for our sins only, but for those of the whole world. The way we may be sure that we know him is to keep his commandments. Those who say, I know him, but do not keep his commandments are liars, and the truth is not in them. But whoever keeps his word, the love of God is truly perfected in him. The word of the Lord.
From the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The two disciples recounted what had taken place on the way, and how Jesus was made known to them in the breaking of the bread. While they were still speaking about this, he stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." But they were startled and terrified and thought they were seeing a ghost. Then he said to them, "Why are you troubled? And why do questions arise in your heart? Look at my hands and my feet, that it is I myself. Touch me and see, because a ghost does not have flesh and bones as you can see I have." And as he had said this, he showed them his hands and his feet. While they were still incredulous with joy and were amazed, he asked them, "Have you anything here to eat?" They gave him a piece of baked fish, and he took it and ate it in front of them. He said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses and in the prophets and Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures. And he said to them, "Thus it is written that the Christ would suffer and rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance for the forgiveness of sins would be preached in his name to all nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good morning, everyone. You know, during Lent, at weekday Mass, our numbers increase pretty significantly because people are doing extra prayer. And during Lent, our Good Samaritans witness a great deal of charity because we're doing a lot of almsgiving. During Lent, there's a lot more activity. We have penance services and extra times for confession because we are coming to seek God's mercy as we get ready for Easter. And all of that is very good. But it sometimes leaves us with the understanding that Lent is all about penance and Easter is all about just joy and happiness and do whatever we'd like. And yet, really, when you look at and listen to the readings over the last few weeks, and today and in the weeks to come, the readings for Sunday liturgy always point us back to mercy. Easter really is a time of reconciliation. When Jesus meets with the disciples for the first time after his resurrection, as we heard last week, the week before, last week, this week, he reconciles them. He gives them his peace. And he brings them back into communion. Why did they need to be reconciled? Well, because all of them fled. Peter denied him three times. They all denied him in one fashion or another. Only John remained. And so they needed to be reconciled to him. Just like if somebody were to desert you, a friend of yours or a family member, to desert you in your most important time of need, you would need to be reconciled with them at some point. And so Jesus comes as that reconciliation. He died on the cross for the forgiveness of sins to, as we heard in the second reading, to reconcile us to God. He is, Paul uses that fancy word, expiation, which means he is the one who sold himself into slavery to get you and me out of slavery. Slavery to what? Slavery to sin. Slavery to our desires. Slavery to those things that are only really about us in the end. Slavery to our selfishness. Slavery to all of those things that really don't help us to be like God, because that's the goal. The goal is to be like God. Jesus says, be like the Father. And so that's our goal. So he reconciles us so that we can do that. We can do that. And he continues to pour his reconciliation on us in this feast of his body and blood, which is a sign of that healing of the rift between us and the divine, between us and God. And he also pours out that reconciliation on us in the sacrament of penance. And so as we hear in that letter of St. John, my sisters and brothers, if you sin, you have an advocate in Jesus. You don't have to wallow in your sin. You don't have to allow the devil to make you feel bad, 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 and then you go to confession, you continue to sin more. That's what he loves to do. The devil loves to do that. He loves to hit us when we didn't do what we knew we were supposed to do, and he makes us feel terrible, and then we just kind of sink into other things. No. You have an advocate, Jesus Christ, who is present in his church, who made it quite clear that he is present in his church. He is present in the sacraments, particularly the sacrament of confession in this regard. And so avail yourself of that. You know, sometimes people go to confession once a year during Lent. Really, we should go more often, because all of us sin. We all do the opposite of what we know we should be doing. We do. None of us are immune from it. None of us. And so we're reminded today, once again, that our new life in Christ is based on the reconciliation he has gained for us, and he continues to pour out on us and invites us to pour out on others. So as we've been reconciled to Christ, we need to reconcile ourselves with others. As Christ has been generous to us, we need to be generous with our mercy to others as well. That is, you know, instead of sometimes condemning people we see on the news or what have you, praying for them. That means if somebody's offended you at work or at home or in the family, you know, to work at praying for them and to forgive them, okay? Because this is the reconciliation we have in our Lord Jesus. And this is the reason for the great joy of Easter. That's the reason for it, is because we have an advocate in Jesus Christ. And he, as he sent out the disciples, so he sends us out as well. And the promise he gives us is that it's not just some nice philosophy for this life. It really prepares us for the resurrection in the end. And as we see in the gospel today, you know, this resurrection is not just like some bodiless spirit. Ultimately, in the end, we are resurrected in our bodies. I don't know how. It's not human science, it's God's science. And he resurrects us in our bodies, just like Jesus. With all of the things that happen to us, Jesus comes back with the wounds. The wounds aren't gone. So the perfection is not necessarily in that. The perfection is in being eternal. Just like God, he makes us that way. And that's the great gift of reconciliation that God gives us. As part of that gift, we have to express it in this life by, I said, obviously, forgiving others, reconciling ourselves with others, being merciful to others. Sometimes that mercifulness takes on a veil or whatever of our generosity towards others in prayer, in treasure, in time, in talent, whatever. Our generosity towards others becomes very important and becomes really a sign to us that we really have appropriated this reconciliation of Jesus. So last week, I spoke about the importance of the Catholic Services appeal, and I appeal to your generous spirit because, first of all, it's good to give back to God in a particular way, in this way, and second of all, because the many things that the Catholic Services appeal accomplish for us on our behalf, things that we could not do as a parish on our own. We could never raise the money to educate our priests. We could never have enough to be able to take care of all the youth in the diocese. We could never have enough to be able to help the sisters in their retirement. That's all of us together need to do that. Okay, and so this week, I ask you to pray about it during this week, and that this Sunday today we would make our commitment. So at the ends of your pews, or in the middle maybe, there's an envelope like this. If you're at the end of the pew, please hand it down to somebody else. So let's all please get an envelope out. Just like this. It says Diocese of Gary on it. So let's all get an envelope out. There's some pins there in the pew as well. Some of you might have a pin. Okay. Now, if you did this already at home, you can write on you know on it. I already did this. Okay. But we're going to do this together now. It's a good thing. It's always a good thing to experience each other's generosity. So I ask you, when you get the envelope, to please take out the card that is inside the envelope. Please take the card out that is inside the envelope. Okay. And on one side, there's different levels of the Bishop's Guild. But the side that we're concerned about today is this front side here, that on the left is our information. We want to make sure we put our parish, St. Michael's, Schererville, Indiana. And then we're going to fill out this other side, the right side, with a donation. The big difference in this card this year is that in the past, if you made a pledge, and I highly encourage you to make a pledge, because if you're able to give $20, $25 a month, you know, or $50, that's great, because then that helps us reach our goal, because this is not a second collection. If it's a second collection, we won't reach our goal. And we have a goal of $112,000. So you might say, oh, that's a lot. We're not the largest parish in the diocese. We're the third or fourth largest. There are parishes that have higher goals than we do, and there are small parishes that have lower goals. Each goal is attuned to the parish's generosity. So a pledge helps, and it's like 9 months, and you know, and you can have it automatically deducted you know, on your credit card. The difference is that this card doesn't allow us to put our credit card number on it. They're concerned about security or whatever. There's this little QR code on the card, and you can take a picture of that, and you could do your credit card that way if you're doing a monthly gift, okay? And also, I wrote on my original one, please contact me for credit card information for the remainder of my pledge, okay? So you can do that as well, whatever is easiest for you. So also there, you would check off your gift altogether, or what you think your monthly pledge would be, you know, or if you're going to give a one-time gift. You can include a down payment in the envelope, a check or cash, and then the balance would be paid over the 9 months, okay? So we're going to take a few moments now, where we're going to fill this out, and then when we're finished filling it out, the hospitality people will come to the front of the aisles with a basket, and I'll ask you to please come forward to put that in the basket. But let's take a few moments now to fill this out.
Thank you.
So if you just seal up your envelope, if we could have the hospitality ministers come to the head of each aisle. So this is not like taking up a collection. They're going to come up to you. So come to the head of each aisle, please. Come to the head of each aisle and just turn around and face the people, and they'll come up to you. And if you're finished, if you bring up your envelope and just place it in the basket. Thank you all very much, and if you were unable to fill out a card today, I encourage you to do so. This is very important to our parish that we reach our goal. Anything over our goal, we get back and comes to us for our use. If we don't reach our goal, it comes out of our regular Sunday offering, and as you know, if you look at our financial report, that pretty much that gets used for other things, so it's very difficult if it has to come out of that. Also, the number of people involved, the number of families making a gift or a pledge is very important. There's even a little contest now this year for if the number, the parish that increases the number of people who participate will receive a cash prize that can go for its ministries in the parish. So please to participate in one fashion or another so that not only we reach our goal, but it'd be wonderful if we showed them that everybody here is very generous and that we receive that cash prize for increasing the number of people that participate. Thank you. Please rise. Will our catechumens please come forward? Today, my dear friends, we have been called to reconcile ourselves with God. He has reconciled himself with us, and that's what your journey is all about, coming to understand how much God loves you and forgives you and wants you to be part of his family. And so I send you forth now with God's word to further reflect upon it and to also to bring yourself to the altar of the Lord.
We stand with you.
And together, using the Apostles' Creed, let us profess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried, descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there, he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Confident of God's love and care for us, we offer our prayers to our Heavenly Father.
For all leaders of the church, may they embody the mysteries of new life which we celebrate in our liturgy. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the church, that we may boldly and faithfully proclaim the resurrection of Christ to those who do not yet believe in it. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all leaders of our nations and the world, may they give priority to those with the greatest need in the distribution of the world's basic resources. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all nations in conflict, may they set aside their differences and work together to end all violence and warfare. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those preparing to receive their first communion and the sacrament of confirmation this spring, may they be open to the presence of Christ, allowing him to transform their lives. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and the suffering, may the peace of Christ bring them comfort and strength and fill them with hope. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the prayers mentioned in our community's Book of Intentions, for all those in the armed forces and their families, for an increase in vocations to the priesthood, diaconate, and religious life, and for all those who have died, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. All-powerful God, in your great mercy, you have made us your children through your Son, our Lord Jesus. By the power of your Spirit, continue to guide us and help us to live in the reconciliation and mercy that you have shown us, so that we may bring that to others. We ask this all through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Oh,
sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord.
Receive, O Lord, we pray, these offerings of your exultant church, and as you have given her cause for such great gladness, grant also that the gifts we bring may bear fruit in perpetual happiness. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and in his rising the life of all has risen. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Therefore, Almighty Father, we bless you through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who comes in your name. He himself is the word that brings salvation, the hand you extend to sinners, the way by which your peace is offered to us. When we ourselves had turned away from you on account of our sins, you brought us back to be reconciled, O God, so that converted at last to you, we might love one another through your Son, who for our sake handed himself over to death. And now, celebrating that reconciliation Christ has brought us, we entreat you, sanctify these gifts by the outpouring of your Spirit, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, whose command we fulfill when we celebrate these mysteries. For when about to give his life to set us free, he reclined at supper. He himself took bread into his hands, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, on that same evening, he took the chalice of blessing in his hands, confessing your mercy, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Celebrating, therefore, the memorial of the death and resurrection of your Son, who left us this pledge of his love, we offer you what you have bestowed on us, the sacrifice of perfect reconciliation. Holy Father, we humbly beseech you to accept us together with your Son, and in this saving banquet, graciously to endow with us his very Spirit, who takes away everything that estranges us from one another. May he make your church a sign of unity and an instrument of your peace among all people. And may he keep us in communion with Francis, our Pope, and Robert, our Bishop, and all the bishops and your entire people. Just as you have gathered us now to the table of your Son, so also bring us together with the glorious Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with your blessed apostles and all of the saints, with our brothers and sisters, and those of every race and tongue who have died in your friendship. Bring us to share with them the unending banquet of unity in a new heaven and a new earth, where the fullness of your peace will shine forth in Christ Jesus our Lord. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen, 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 amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of our Lord Jesus be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer to our neighbor the peace of Christ.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Look with kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those you were pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Will the children please come forward, all the children. As you do, we have just a reminder that we have coffee and donuts after Mass this Sunday. And so we invite you to go back and enjoy. Also, I'd like to thank the Art and Environment team for all their hard work in decorating for the Easter season. And they keep up our flowers for this whole time. I'd like to thank them very much for that. My dear children, please bow your heads. Almighty God, we ask you to send your blessing upon our young brothers and sisters. Keep them always joyful in spirit, knowing that they have been healed and reconciled to you by Jesus, and help them to show that same mercy to the people whom they meet in their lives every day. We ask you to bless them, keep them safe. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, amen. Thank you. Do you have talent with art? Are you one of those scrapbookers? The VBS, the Vacation Bible School team, is looking for someone to run the art station, and all the materials are provided. So for more information, please contact our Director of Religious Ed, Kimberly Hoogerveen, at the Faith Formation office. That number is in the bulletin. Our stewardship challenge for this week is to reflect this week on the times that Jesus has come to your aid. You are a witness of his presence, as he said in the gospel. And so share your experience of support the risen Lord has given you in your life with someone else. The Lord be with you.
Bow down for the blessing.
May God, who by the resurrection of his only begotten Son was pleased to confer on you the gift of redemption and adoption, give you gladness by his blessing.
Amen.
May he, whose redeeming work you have received the gift of everlasting freedom, make you heirs to an eternal inheritance.
Amen.
And may you, who have already risen with Christ in baptism through faith, by living in a right manner on this earth, be united with him in the homeland of heaven.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah to the Lord. Sing hallelujah.
hallelujah, sing hallelujah, hallelujah to the Lord. Sing his praise, sing his praise.